Welcome back to another video. Now today, we're going to be doing a full intro tutorial on Panzoid, which is a free website that you can use. And yeah, it's probably really long, but yeah. Hopefully this doesn't take 2 days to upload. Alright, so you want to select your audio file. I've already done that because don't want to show my files. And what you do is you should turn on the waveform because that helps you with the keyframes. And now you want to select your offset, which is when you want the drop to happen. So I'm gonna go, because I've already seen this song. Also, I'm going to change this to 60 frames and this to probably 20. And have a fade in and a fade out here. I'm going to set this to 3 on both. So close to love, but you had to go and mess it up. Okay, so I'm going to go 45. Let's try that. I'm gonna end it about here, but let's try 40. This is where the beat drop will be. I'm gonna make this 2 instead. Okay. There you've got your fade in and fade out. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna add some text. Make sure you click this eye down here so it'll toggle the render preview. I'm just gonna name this tutorial, but you can name it your name when you're doing this. Now you want to choose your font. I'm gonna be choosing one of these fonts in here. Let's go with American Captain. So now, move on to the text later. We're just doing the sync right now. That's what I like to do first anyways. So you're gonna find the drop, which... So, once you've got the drop, go to add effect and search duplicate. Now you'll see it'll go into a grid. Just turn this multiply back down to 1. Now, what you want to do is add a keyframe, make it none, and put it at 0.8 or 0.7. I'm going to go with 0.7 because this is quite a hard base. So, now you just want to go to every kind of beat. You hear how it goes like bang. So, you're going to add the same keyframe and just make sure you don't just click the plus. You have to turn this to none. And I just go along and do that. By the way, this is Captain Nick 88 Sync. I'll link that in the description as well. By the way, the song I'm using is So Close. Just search that up. It's probably the first result. Just add this one just in case. And now you want to go back to the start of all these keyframes and go over here to the second one, start of this one, make this quadratic in and set it to 1. Now you want to drag this over every second keyframe. And by the way, how I'm copying this is you hold Alt and then you click and drag, and it'll duplicate it. So you just do that every second one, skipping past one each time. Just like that. And now, go back to the start again, and come to the front of the first keyframe. Now you want to click one, make this just linear. And now do the same, drag it to every second one, hold Alt and drag. And then at the last one, just put a linear at the end. So now, like this. Yeah, we got so close, so close to love. But you had to go and mess it up. Was it all too much? Mess it up. Was it all too much? Alright, so now we're going to move on to the shake. So, what you want to do is go over onto the duplicate still and go to where it zooms in. You see how it zooms in? So keep your frame and your little line here on that and go to the camera settings. And now keep everything the same except the shake speed. Make that 10. And don't do advanced shake settings. You don't need to do that. Now, you add a keyframe for the shake, add a none keyframe, and add 0.005. Actually, no, just keep this linear. So now, go to wherever it zooms in, and add another one. You can use your arrows to scroll along, by the way. I'm quite quick at this because I've been doing intros for quite a bit now. By quite a bit, I mean like a few months. That's it? Okay. Now you're gonna go in front of it and add one for zero. So now you just keep a zero keyframe here, linear, and move and get that keyframe and copy it again and put this in front of everyone. And then after, should look like that. Yeah, we got so close, so close to love. But you had to go and mess it up. Mess it all so much. Alright, now we're gonna make the transitions at the start and end. So, what you're gonna do is go into the effects and get a shutter. Now this one is going to be a radial. We'll make this white, just so we can see. And you're going to make it 0.5 on the cover. That's 0.6. Make it 0.5 on the cover. Now go to where the first drop is. You should have seen here where it zooms in. So make this 0.5. And add a keyframe. Make this a none. 0.5. Now go forward a little bit and make another keyframe. Make this a circular out and make this 0. Yeah, we got so close, so close to love. So now you got a smooth start transition. Yeah, we got so close. Now what you do is duplicate this with this little two squares button and go to the one under the first one and make this black. Then move these two keyframes forward a little bit until the white appears. And do this to your preference. Yeah, we got so close. 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 This add another shutter, and this one is going to be a linear. So now make this one white as well and make the angle, just turn it until it suits your preference. I'm gonna make it come down from the top right just like this, so then it kind of goes like that. Go and now set this to 0 and find where your beat drop is, where you want it to end. Add a keyframe, none for 0. Move forward a little bit and make the cover circular out and 0.5. There you go. you go, you got your end transition, but we're going to do the same thing. Going to duplicate this, make it black, and move these to the right this time. You got your start and end transitions. Now let's get the text. So add a group and move this into here. I'm just gonna call this rotate, then add another group and call this flatten. Now put this rotate group inside the flatten group by hovering and making sure the box is hovered over it. And then you've got this in here. Now, you need to get on the rotate group, and on the rotation, do negative 20, negative 20 on these two right here. Not this one, because this is the spin. You don't want that. So do this, and I know it looks weird now, but go to the flatten group, and on this bottom right scale here, do 0.1, and now you can see that it's flattened just like this. Now what you should do is go to the effects and add an anti-aliasing just like this, and add another one if you want, and there you go, nice and clean. Now with this, I'm gonna make this 5, and duplicate this, make sure the line is under this, and make it in the same group. Now go to the bevel and turn this on, then make the thickness 4, which is 1 lower, and now make the color whatever you want. I'm gonna go with the purple. That looks nice. What if we make this one 5 and this one 6? What if we make this one 4 and this one 3? No, we'll keep this one 4 and 5. Okay. There you go. So now you've got your text. That's all done and dusted. So now you can close that group. I'm just gonna do this slash text so I know that it's the text. Now, add a group. That's particles, don't wanna add them. Add a group, call it BG for background, and add an object, shape, rectangle, put it in this group. Make it about negative, we'll go 40. And make the width just big, and the height big, make it extra thick, and make sure that when it comes out all the way from the sink, when it zooms out, that this doesn't come back. And do that where there's black bars. So put this in negative 40 and just make this massive. So now you got a massive rectangle looking thing. Okay. Yeah, we got it. But now, since it's white, we don't really want that. So I'm going to make this a dark purple in the background. There we go. So now you can see the white at the start and end transitions. And there we go. Now go into effects and let's see if we can add a bloom. Now it'll look really weird. Just turn the amount to 0.5 in my opinion. And boom, great. Maybe change it to 0.4. Yeah, that looks better. All right, now you see these have got a little bit of a glow. If you can see, if I turn this off, looks a bit dull. Then this looks nice and bright. So once you've got that, what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a group. We're gonna call this blinds. Now if you've seen those donut looking things, I know that sounds weird, but if you see this and change the outer radius to 4, you see it looks like this. If you've seen these things in intros and they have little lines going through them, that's what the blinds are for. Now this does only work if you have a plain background. If you're using packs and different animated backgrounds, this will not work. You just need a solid background in Panzoid. So you're going to add a shape rectangle and make sure that it is in front of the distance that the BG is. So this is negative 40. You would want this to be in the blinds. You would want this to be about negative 25 will go. Now make the width just really wide and make the height a bit lower. Well, I'm gonna go with 4 because that looks like a nice width and height. So we'll go with that and get this color in the rectangle on the background and double click on the outside of it and then Control C to copy it. Go back to this rectangle, go into the color, double click on the outside and Control V to paste it, choose, and boom, it blends in with the background. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just change this to a white for now, just so we can see these. And now you go like this, duplicate this a bunch of times, and then put these all in the same group just like that. And now you just want to make this number negative 10. Oh wait, no, not that number. You want to do this one. So we'll go negative 10. Nope. What about negative 8? Negative 5? Nope. Negative 7. There we go. Alright. So now you're going to have to go up in sevens. So we'll go 7, and then we'll go 14. Next one. Actually, let's go with 8. That looks a bit better. Negative 16. Yeah, that looks a bit better. And negative 24. Negative 32. Negative 40. Negative 48. Negative 56. And make sure that you can see all of them when it zooms out. So I'm just going to make one more. And we're going to go negative, where is it? 64. And if you go out of here, see, there's all of them. Now, what you want to do now is what you can do is just add another group. Call it blinds, but make this blinds 1. Now put this in the blinds group, and you can just copy this, put this in the same group, name this blinds 2 and rotate this 180 degrees. Boom, little trick for you there. And just like that, you got your full blinds, just like that. So now, once you go to your rectangle and put the same color back in, boom, all gone. And just like that, you've got your blinds. Now you can close both of them up, make a new group, call this donuts. Now, what you want to do is go to add object, shape, donut. Put this in here, make the outer radius 4, like before, and make the radius big-ish. So, if you see, if we go back, it'll make the lines in the blinds, but we want to switch from this to this every donut. So, just bring this forward a little bit, and make sure when it comes out, it's big enough. So I'm going to go with the tube radius, and I'm going to turn that down to 8 or 9. I don't know. Yeah, we got. Let's go with 8. Yeah, we got. Go with 65 as the radius. Yeah, we got so close, so close to. Yep, that looks good. And now what we'll do is, when this comes, which you know the beat drop is right on that beat drop, you know that. Now make the scale on this one 0 and 0. It'll put 0.1 at the end, that doesn't matter. And put a keyframe, put this at none, make sure this is straight, and move forward until it zooms in once more. Go one behind that, add another keyframe, make this circular out, and 1, 1. And now, there we go. See how it zooms in, and the donut appears. There we go. There we go. And now on this one, you want to add another keyframe, make this none, and then come out until the next zoom in, go one behind, and then make this circular out, and make this like until it comes off screen. So we'll go 3. We can't go. Let's go 2.5. Nope. Okay, we'll go with 3. We can't go. But as you can see, that's a little bit fast. So we're going to change this to a quadratic out. There we go. Maybe not. Keep this at a circular out and just move it along a little bit. There we go. Okay, boom, there you go. Now we're gonna copy this one, put it in the same group, copy these keyframes. So what you want to do is hold shift and click all these keyframes to highlight them all, then drag them until this front bit is at the next drop right here. So now, there you go. But now we'll move these two back until this second one is on the next drop. So now it goes. But that is wrong, because I'm an idiot. Move this back, I missed this drop. Right here. And boom, that's already done. Just like that. But this one, as I said before, you want it to be like this. So just drag it back a little bit and then make the radius a little bit more and the thickness a bit more, just like that. Make this 10, the radius, and maybe not, I'll make it 9, just like that. And there you go. Now get this one, which is this one that's not got the stripes in it, copy this one, put it under. Now highlight all these keyframes like we did before by holding shift, and move this until the front one is on here. Now move this, make sure this second one here is on the beat drop. Yeah, we get so close, so close. Just like that. Now get the one before it, which is the striped one, and then copy these keyframes and move them. Move it to the next drop, and then we have to move this forward, and boom. And at this beat drop here, it's kind of like it changes into a new kind of pattern, or it kind of stops for a little bit. We're gonna make that turn into like the circle ones instead of these triangle looking ones. But for now, just keep going with these. That one's good. This one. Okay, about two more until we'll switch this up. Okay, so it's there. Yeah. Okay, one more, just like this. And boom, 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 boom. Just like that. Okay, so now copy this one again, but what we're gonna do is gonna make the outer radius just bleh, just make it massive until it turns into a circle. So you see how it's like all lines, and just keep going until it looks really smooth and it looks like a circle. I'll just go with 200. And then we'll move these keyframes up to where, is it here? Yeah, right here. Just like that. So now you can see it comes out in a circle. So now we're gonna do the same with this one. Make the outer radius 200. And then move this down this way. Just like there. Just like the other ones. And keep going with this as well. Whoop, just got rid of that one. Make this one again. Okay, so now if we play it from the start. Yeah, we got so close, so close to your. But you had to go and mess it up. Mess it up. Need one more. Almost perfect. Actually, we'll do that again. Work on the text animations so you can close up the donuts and that. So now we can rotate this, we can do all that jazz. But the thing is, this goes into the back, so let's just move this forward a little bit. Yep. And then just make the scale like 0.9. There we go. Yeah, we got so close, so close to your. But you had to go and mess it. Okay, sorry. Yeah, we got so close, so close to. Yeah, we got so close, so close to your. Don't know where to add a spin. We got so close, so close to your. But you. Alright, let's go to the camera, because I know I want to do one here. But you. So we'll go from here and we'll go to rotation, add a none, and then go. So this one here is where I want it to spin. So we're gonna add another one here. Make this circular in out and make this go this way. So we'll do 360. Just like this. There we go. Easy as that. Now let's add a rotation for this one. Make another keyframe over here. Make this a circular in out as well. And we'll make this go like this. So we'll do 360. Just like that. Yeah, we got so close to your. But you had to. something over here. So add another duplicate here. Make this one. So where it goes boom boom, I want it to go like slide to the left and to the right. So we're gonna go from here, add an offset keyframe, make this none. And then make a little bit after, I think, and then make it a circular out. And then we'll go like negative 0.25, like that. Like this. And then make another none keyframe here. And then go past this and make another circle in out and put this 0.25. And boom. Actually, let's move these back because these two here, we need a spot where it can come back to. And add another none keyframe here. And out here, we'll make this circle in out back to zero. So let's see if this works as a circular. Nope. Go back to the circular. Out and out. Let's make this duplicate go from here, none, and then here, circle in out, make this go to 3, and then go back with another circle in out to 1. Make another rotation on this text, and let's make this a none here, and then over here make this a circular in out and make this a 360. Let's make you have to go and mess it up. just make the text like go boom and then boom and like swing a little bit, you could call it. I don't know. We're gonna go here, rotation, and then we're gonna make it about like 0, and then go here and make it circular in out and go 5. What about 10? I think we should go about 20 maybe. And make another circle in out. And we'll go negative 20. And now make this a circular now and make this back to 0. Just working out where I could put this effect. I'm thinking about here. So we'll go to the duplicate, make this a none, and then come across here. Make another one, this one's circular in out. Make this come across here for 2. Just like this. What if we put this above the shutters? Will that like... Okay, yeah, that's good. So now the shutters won't move with it. Yeah, we get so close. Yeah, we get so close. So close to your... Whoops, okay. So close, so close to... Now let's make this just go back to 0, so nothing happened. Yeah, we get so close, so close to your... Okay, because before it was still stuck on 2, so it would go to the side. Yeah, we get so close, so close to your... But you had to go and mess it up. Looking pretty good. What else could we add?
Yeah, we got it.
think that's about it. Yeah, we got so close, so close to love. But you had to go and mess it up. Alright. Wait, what if we put this boom back at 0.5? Yeah, we got so close, so close to love. Yeah, I think that looks a bit better. Alright, now that's about it for that. So now we go to, I'm just gonna save this, so in case it crashes or something. Make sure to save it if you want to edit it or something. But after that, go to this download button, go to the balance and change that to good or extreme quality. I'm just gonna go good. And start video render. And after you got that, you got your video and it's done. So thank you so much for watching this incredibly long video. Hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.